Hello, hello. Let's try that again, shall we? Lu'an here doing our Maori oracle reading. I was going to say goddess then, but it's not the goddess reading. So I have a little bit of a story before I tell you about the three cards that I pulled today. I've been on holidays down in Lawn, beautiful part of Victoria, just with the kids and my partner for a little bit. And it's a lovely little breakaway. So it kind of feels like Monday today for me. But anyway, getting back into it, it's kind of a bit slow. So I want to tell you about these cards, actually. So the Maori Oracle, and you can find them on Facebook. So Polly, P.A. Manel is the creator, and her name is Polly. And sadly, Polly, I don't know if you saw, I shared some of her work about the warrior a couple of nights ago. Probably a week ago now, and it just so happened, the reason why I'm talking about her today is that her partner actually contacted me. Her husband, he's been still releasing some of her work. She was an amazing author and has written many books, so he put a book together called Polyisms, which I am about to order very soon. And it just so happened he came onto my business page, and the reason why was because he had seen some of the readings that I'd been doing up on YouTube, and he was researching something. So we got to chatting, and it was really insightful, really intuitive man, and it kind of feels like Polly is still reaching out, getting her work out into the world. So I'm quite honoured to be sharing her work. If you want to get the Maori Oracle, you can Facebook it. There's a page here on Facebook where you can order them. But anyway, I digress, because the reason kind of got a bit freaky there for a minute, because he was saying he was researching her on the internet, and she had another name that she went by. And I will tell you that name in a moment, but about a month ago at our last goddess gathering, the previous one before, I was doing an exercise with the group, and we were coming up for a name that spoke to us. And for those who were there, you know what I'm talking about here. And we all came up with this name, a different name, but there were actually three women in the group that came up with the same name. And that name was Violet. Okay, so stay with me here. The name was Violet. And as I was chatting to Polly's partner, he was saying Polly used to go by another name, and it was Miss Violet, right? So kind of at that moment I went, wow, that is so interesting. I did tell him, I run these goddess gatherings, and that night we were using these cards and my own oracle deck, and Violet came out three times. So take from that what you want to, but I took it as kind of a message that, yeah, there's still some work to be done as I'm diving deeper into my Maori heritage as well. So that's why I love sharing these cards with you. Freaky, right? Anyway, freaky or not freaky. So I already pulled the three cards for this week's reading, and I'm going to go through them right now. So this first card is called the Koreke. Koreke, yes, the Koreke. And it's a bird. And an old story from the South Island of New Zealand teaches that in one's own personal universe, one must walk the path that is best for him or her. As tonight, I am actually doing the first Path to Purpose gift marking class live. So it's interesting that Koreke has come up. And the Koreke was very close friends with the Pākeke. So the Pākeke is the seal. And each tried to convince the other to come and live where he preferred to be. So the Pākeke finally stated that he was going to live in the sea, the seal, and turned to go. And the Koreke pleaded with him to stay. But he said that if he had stayed, he would be too easy to kill and would be killed for his meat. And so after a difficult farewell, the two separated forever. And the Koreke, the bird, to the land, and the Pākeke, the seal, to the sea. And the message from this card is self-truth. be as you must. And so again, tonight we're going to go into the path of purpose. So this card to me is well-meaning friends. Hey Maggie, hey Tamara. Well-meaning friends or family, sometimes they want you to walk a different path, or a path that to them can be easier. But again, these two, the seal and the bird, they knew what their path was, and they were strong enough to stay on that path. And unfortunately, they had to separate. So if you have someone who's kind of wanting to guide you in a certain way, but you know in your heart, you know your own truth, that that's not the way where you have to follow. So that's the Korike card there. Our next card is the Mato. We call it the Mato, and it's a fish hook. So last week I actually was watching, is it Moana, and put up a post, who cries at Moana? And yes, so you'll notice the hook is Maui's hook. And so the story behind this, a good fisherman knows that to catch any type of fish, you need to fish with the right bait, in a particular place at a particular time. And sometimes it can take a long time to work out these variables. And even then, you must be patient and persevere. In doing so, eventually abundance will be yours. So when I'm feeling into this card, this hook, I don't know if any of you know about ClickFunnels, if you've heard ClickFunnels. It's a marketing company, and it's a great, well, I've been doing a 30-day challenge with them, and they use the word hooks, not in a bad way, but in a way to attract people to you, right? So you've got to use the right bait, the right hook, and then you can support them. So this kind of just reminds me of this, and I was speaking to somebody today, doing a coaching call with them, and there was a problem. She wanted to actually fill her events. Hey Nicole, good to see you. We'll see you tonight on the Path to Purpose gift marking class. And her hook, when I was looking at what she was trying to hook people in, and she's got amazing business, amazing ideas and amazing services, but she wasn't using the right bait, so to speak. And so people couldn't see her message. So if you are actually in the process of, if you have a service or a product that you want to share with other people, you know that to persevere with that. It's okay, it takes patience, but also you've got to be really clear on your message, right? So I've done that many times. It's like, try something and it doesn't work. And it's like, oh, I get it now. This is what I need to share with people so they know what my message is. How do you start a movement? So that's the hook. And it means opportunity born of determination. With diligence and patience, you will benefit. So stick at it, persevere at it. Okay. So our last and final, last one. Oh, this is a new card for me. I haven't pulled this one. Look at this. It looks like so gross. It's a wetter. It's a wetter. It's kind of like a, what is it? It's a cave wetter, like a big bug. They're not very nice to look at, but anyway. So it's named specifically for its ugliness, and it looks dangerous and fierce, but truthfully, the wetters are harmless. The great spike of its tail is for laying eggs. See the spike there? It can bite, but most likely won't. The wetter typo doesn't even hunt much, preferring to scavenge off the cave floor at night, nor will it come out on moonlit nights where there's too much light for it to feel safe. And the card actually means your fears are unfounded. So again, it just looks ugly, right? Doesn't even come out that much, doesn't do much. So what fears are holding you back right now? And I know, I just keep banging on about beliefs and fears. So we can make up this whole story about things that aren't even true. Yet we will live our life by these untruths that are not even seen until we kind of get out and use our courage and step up. Yeah, so if you have some fears at the moment, this card here, what is it? The Witter Taipo means it's a no-go. Don't worry about it. Put it to the back and keep moving forward. So those are the three cards today. Hopefully that makes sense to some of you. Does to me. So there you go. I am on doing the Path to Purpose gift marking, which is part of the Path to Purpose bonuses for the tickets for the tour that I'm doing. If you, there is still time to obviously join us because they're all around the country. And if you want to, I will put a link up. But look into what these cards would mean. Maybe one is, means more to you than the other. But yeah, they're really beautiful. And if you missed my story about how I got onto this oracle and the violet name, go back and watch it. It was really kind of cool. All right. Many blessings to you. Bye for now.